Smart Wargames here. Let's do a short tutorial on how to get convenient WASD camera controls in Viking Steel. Because I've noticed the game, it has good camera controls, but the free camera controls, they are on the numpad. And sure, if you play a long time, I guess they become natural, but for me it was still a bit somewhat cumbersome. And yeah, I use sometimes for games like this, I use a tool called AutoHotkey. And it's a general tool that allows you basically for every game to fix things like this, to bind, rebind keyboard hotkeys now. And yeah, if you install it, you get this option here to create a new AutoHotkey script. I will simply show mine. You can simply copy it, it is not much text, you simply can open it with a text editor. And that's the options. I will use WASD for strafing, like in modern, I don't know, strategy games. QE for, what do you call it? Yeah, for, you know, left-right turns. And XC for go up low, and I can show it you, I will load it. I always load them in admin mode, because I sometimes notice that if you play something, they might not get recognized. And keep in mind that, I was thinking that's commenting out, I think that's comment out. Yeah, I just wanted to test something out, because sometimes I get stuck. I use this also in Chatland for camera controls, and I have sometimes this issue when you do a lot of camera movement that a camera key gets stuck. I had a fix for it back then, I forgot how it was to fix. Somebody said remove the send input. Yeah, it is now active, and keep in mind that now your WASD keys are rebinded, even in Windows. So I will play the campaign with it, Thunder at Sea. This campaign module, I don't see that there was some need for hotkeys. And yeah, let's go into the game and check it. That's the campaign engine. I already have the game running. Yeah, it is sniped, but that's fine. Let's get to some ship. Okay. Yeah, and by moving it around, and look at this now. This is beautiful, perfect camera controls. You can move around here, you can fly around with some training, you can, sure it's now dark, but you can, yes, if I get in combat, we get illuminated anyways. This is really a relief, because I'm absolutely not a num block guy. It was back in the days, it was standard arrow keys and num block, but I grew really to this WASD, because it's most, for me, also most comfortable with the hand. Simply lying on the side, otherwise I need to put the hand on the other side of the keyboard, which is rather unnatural. Okay, nothing happening here. But yeah, looks perfect. You can raise the altitude XC. Use, of course, those keys that float your boat. Finally, something happening here. This is free. And you can also use it for Chatland. And looks like this time it doesn't get stuck. I think perhaps the send input, I'm really stressing the camera right now. Yeah, but if it happens that it gets stuck, you can unstuck the camera by pressing the key that is stuck. So if your camera moves left, press the key once that is left, and it stops. That is simply something I heard, it has something to do with Windows, UAC, I don't know, whatever. I disabled the send input now for testing, and it seems I can't get the camera stuck by overdoing it. Was something like an overflow or whatever happening there. Ah, this is really great. I'm really excited, because this numlock was always giving me a brain twist. Because yeah, some keys are, it's fine, it has a system, I get it, but this is way better. And I usually don't use hotkeys in Fighting Steel, I use the interface. Of course, there are hotkeys, there might be functions on those WASD QE. But yeah, if you need to quickly deactivate it, you can go here and suspend hotkeys. Let's see if it works. For example, if you need to type something, because of course you can't, yeah, they're now disabled, because you can of course not type. Yeah, that's it.